Fighters produced by Soundman Enterprises Inc., Mobile Solutions, CT Sounds, and Extreme Autosports. Last episode, I did enough complaining to last the entire T-Bird build, and I embarrassed my son. That's two things out of the way. All that complaining, and that was only the easy part. Today, it's time to get serious and quit fucking around. I'm taking a vow to never complain again. As long as you guys shut the fuck up. How am I supposed to finish this shit? If you won't shut the fuck up in the comments. I'm not one to complain, but... Jesus fucking... Everyone says I should stick to building speaker boxes. Instead of performing high-end mechanic work on luxury vehicles.
So we gotta remove these bolts, remove the power steering pump, remove the oil pan and gasket. Remove cooling fan, motor, fan blade, and shroud assembly. Loosen water pump pulley bolts. Remove the drive belt and water pump pulley. Raise the vehicle. Remove the bolts retaining the power steering pump to the cylinder block. The front lower bolt on the pump will not come all the way out. Wire the power steering pump out of the way. Do not disconnect the fluid lines. Remove the oil pan and gasket. So we're gonna take this off.
We're just going to take this one bolt at a time. Right now, I need to remove the power steering pump so I can drop the whole goddamn subframe. I'm not one to complain, but...
So there's one bolt there, and then one up there. Oh!
So I was staring at my own asshole in the mirror this morning, and I had a great idea for the T-Bird. Half of you are excited about the T-Bird build, the other half are shitting on the T-Bird. How could you? Must be crazy. This is the final outcome of Jack Telnak's legendary MN12 chassis design. Jack Telnak is also the real person that the famous character Jack Tripper from the show Three's Company was based off of. Except Jack Tripper was a chef, and Jack Telnak is a car designer. But other than that, let me tell you, Jack really was tripping when he designed the T-Bird. Jack really must have been tripping when he designed everything in the way of the power steering bolts. What Jack Telnak designed to be impossible is complete. The power steering pump is removed. See what you can accomplish when you're not complaining?
It doesn't matter what your name does.
Like a little bitch. Now I need to pop the oil pan out.
I don't know how I'm supposed to get the fucking oil pan off.
To remove the oil pan, we must first unbolt the motor and drop the subframe. I'm not one to complain, but Jack Telnak is tripping if he thinks I'm gonna drop the subframe. What? What's a subframe?
What?
These are all blown out.
I need to pull apart some of the front suspension to drop the subframe, but before I do that, I'm gonna run to Harbor Freight and grab an engine support bar to support the engine while we drop the subframe.
Now I gotta put some dumb shit together so I can take some dumb shit apart. I'm not one to complain.
Or anything. But this engine support bar from Harbor Freight is really nice. It went together nicely, it's fine. I thought it was gonna be a piece of shit, but... Tools don't count towards the cost of the T-Bird build. That's a shop investment. You're not gonna make a customer pay for the jigsaw you used to build their shitty speaker box. And you get to keep the jigsaw? The customer paid for it. $200 for that box? Is what customers used to tell me when I was done with it. I once charged a customer for a set of crimpers so I could put a stereo in. So I got Snap-on ones. And a set of Matco backup. Turns out he had a set of Klein crimpers in his glove box the whole time. So I took those two. So basically what I need to do is support the engine from the top so I can unbolt the motor from the subframe and drop the subframe enough to get the oil pan off. Once the oil pan's off, I could take the timing cover off. Then we need to not fuck up the timing when we pull the pulleys off. Or the sprockets. Or whatever the fuck. And then we need to pop the heads off real quick. Drop them off at the machine shop once they tell me they're perfect and they have barely any miles on them. Slap them back in with a new head gasket done after we put it all back together. What I like about installing car stereo systems is that there's no gears and shit to fuck up, unless you have a Jensen chain drive amp. You can't fuck your timing up on your Jensen chain drive. A lot of you said this motor is trash and I should just swap the motor, which we could still do if this doesn't work out. But what you guys don't understand is that this car only has 14,000 miles on it. And that's not a joke. It sounds like I'm fucking around right now. But this is actually Grandma's T-Bird. And then Grandson took it out when there was no coolant in it. And he fucking blew the head gasket like a little prick, stuck it back in Grandma's goddamn carport. In her mobile home fucking thing. Wasn't a garage because the interior's all dried up. The dumb bitch. You should have put a car cover on it. You can see the odometer says 014651. I'll buttfuck her grandson. Look what he did. He's got me over here busting my goddamn knuckles because his stupid ass didn't check the coolant. And look at the interior panels. None of the rubberized finish is like messed up or peeled up. The carpet kit and the seats don't look that worn. The driver's seat doesn't even look like it's been got in and out of a lot, you know? There's not a whole lot of wrinkling. It's definitely weathered. There's a crack on the dash. You know, this color's all faded, especially at the top of the seat. Not a whole lot of fingernail scratches. This could have been repainted because there's a little bit of overspray on one of the fender linings. But there's no Bondo. There's a few dents though. This looks like it could have been replaced and repainted. The body line lines up good though. So I'm thinking that the car wasn't driven for a long time with a blown head gasket, so I don't think a lot of damage happened to the internals of the motor. It could have been a faulty head gasket from the factory for all we know. Maybe we can turn it in under the lemon law. Get a brand new one. Straight from Jack Telnack's garage. Swap it under warranty, you know?
So far, every bolt and nut is where it goes, where it came out of. Everything I'm taking off, I'm just putting the nuts and bolts back where they go. Except for these. These are power steering pump. One bolt's still in the pump, doesn't come out all the way. So those will have to go back in. Just so I don't forget where everything goes. These are even in. This is the alternator support bracket. All these bolts are in place. EGR valve. Valve cover bolt for this side. These have little clips that go with them. I'm not sure where to hook this up, but I know I need to pull the timing cover off. So I don't want to hook it up to any of these. I just need to hold this up while I pull the subframe off.
Now before I make like a fetus and abort my suspension, I'm going to organize my parts. Look at that. I'm already ready to put the hydraulics on the front suspension and the car doesn't even run yet. That's how fast I am. I did it again.
It doesn't matter what you did, Doug.
A lot of you think I'm crazy for trying to polish a thunder turd. But Jack Telnack once told me, never look a gift bird in the nose. You should have seen the mule when I first got it. Its motor was also full of water from the sprinklers. It was sitting in a yard, a bare metal shell. Now look at it. A turd dipped in Bondo is what it turned out to be. I did it.
It doesn't matter what you...
Never look a gift bird in the nose means if somebody gives you a bird, you don't inspect its beak for flaws. You fucking take it. And you'd be happy with the bird. Don't be some sort of spoiled brat. A free car is a free goddamn car. I'm so confident that this motor is gonna go back together, start right up, and purr like a bird, that I'm gonna go ahead and slap hydraulics on the car before it runs. And also I need to hop the front end so I can find all the nuts and bolts, shake them out of the engine bay. Thank you guys so much for always coming back. Leave a comment, let me know what you think about today's episode. I'll see you guys next time. Support Amplified by buying iPad dash kits and Soundman merch at soundmanca.com. Become a car audio master with the tools and trainings available from Mobile Solutions at mobilesolutions-usa.com. Receive a discount on all the best car audio equipment from CT Sounds by using coupon code SOUNDMAN at ctsounds.com. And come down to see me and Rafa at Extreme Autosports in Santa Clarita and get great deals on audio and performance equipment and installation.